Hey guys, so I went and tempted myself today, knowing full well that I was on a no-buy or a no-buy month and a low-buy year. And I went to 10 different charity shops in Newtown and in Surrey Hills, and I spent about 3.5 hours rummaging through those 10 op shops. So I'll show you and I'll tell you what happened. Okay, so I am home now, and let me preface this vlog by saying that I had full intention of spending money today when I went to the op shops because it's January and it is my birthday month, and it's the Sunday just before my birthday. My birthday is on Tuesday. So I thought, you know what? I'm gonna spend the rest of the $100 Australian dollars that I allotted for the month. I had already spent $60 on that wool coat that I bought, which I posted over at the Low Buy Beauty's Facebook account. And for those who don't belong to that group or don't follow that account, it is this beautiful wool coat. It's summer in Australia. It made no sense for me to buy this, but I had been looking for the perfect wool coat for the last two winters. This coming winter would be the third winter. And I finally found one that was the right material. I've seen a lot of wool coats before, but they were all like pretty much like polyester and synthetic material. This one is 70% wool and 30% alpaca, with the lining completely viscose. Okay, anyway, I digress. So yeah, I had every intention of spending the remaining $40 of my budget, and I sort of like justified it by saying that it's impossible for me to do a no-buy in January because it is my birthday month. So I'm moving my no-buy month to February, which is also kind of cheating because February is a short month. Although I think this year it is a leap year, so it's 29 days. It's only a day short of what a normal month would be. Okay, anyway, so in February I'm going to be doing a no-buy. January turned out to be a low-buy, and then the rest of the year will be a low-buy. So I went to 10 different op shops today, and like I said in the very beginning of this video, I spent about 3.5 hours rummaging through those op shops. Now, in the first op shop, and I don't think I was able to film a clip from it, but the first op shop there were two coats, and I don't know why I'm so obsessed with coats lately, but there were two coats that I was really interested in. One was a Zara woman coat, and it was a white sort of like biker style jacket. It's not wool, it's all made of synthetic material. It's just one of the reasons why I didn't buy it. It was $45. It still had a tag on, but it had a few stains, and when I read the care instructions, it said professional dry clean only. So I didn't want to buy something that was already stained and it was like pure white. If I can find a jacket that's similar to it, I'm gonna post it on here so you have an idea of what I'm talking about. But yeah, it had some stains, and I didn't wanna have to deal with getting the stains removed, or if it doesn't get removed, then it's there, and I just spent $45 on a jacket that I don't even know if I'm gonna wear. Because when I tried it on, it just like, it wasn't my style, okay? It wasn't my style. The thing with the decluttering that I've been doing in the last couple of months, actually, is that I was able to hone in on what style I like and what style suits me, and that jacket certainly was not that style. The next jacket was a Michael Kors It was more of like a blazer style jacket. It had lighter material and not, I wouldn't call it a coat. Okay, it's something that you would wear in the fall, autumn period, not in the winter. So it was a beige, almost camel coat. It was sort of like a short trench coat, more like a pea coat. Yeah. So, and it was nice, it was pretty, but I was like, and it was $45 as well for Michael Kors. I thought that was a good deal. But I thought, do I really need this? I just bought this beige wool, this camel wool coat. And I do have a supply and design by Ralph Lauren that looks pretty much like that, just longer. So I didn't end up buying anything there. The second place that I went to was Knopf's. Sorry, there's a bus passing by. Was the Knopf's op shop on King Street in Newtown. The U-turn Vintage was also on King Street. So I went to Knopf's op shop and I tried on three pairs of jeans there, one of which I almost bought. It was a Levi's 510. That was the design, or that was the category that was on, and it was the perfect high-rise pair of jeans, and it was $5. So I was like, yes, score. But something in me said that you have about seven pairs of jeans plus one wide leg pants that's made of denim. Do you really need this jeans? And it almost felt like my subconscious was trying to dissuade me from actually buying this $5 pair of jeans. Because then I started looking for damages, which I don't normally do, to be honest, when I go thrifting. And there it was. I found a hole near the crotch area. It was a tiny hole, no bigger than the tip of my little pinky. But that was enough to make me go, nope, I'm not buying that. So I left. I went to the Australian Red Cross, still on the same street, and found a few things there, tried on two Marc Jacobs coats, and I think I have a clip of that. One of them was a thick black coat that's also made of wool. I think it was a wool blend. But that one was a no. Actually, both of them were a no, and I think I explained why in that clip, so let me go into that clip. Okay, so I'm trying on this Marc Jacobs jacket here. You know about the short sleeves. What do you got? What do you think? I mean, it looks cute. It looks cool, but sleeves are a bit short. And then I tried on this one as well, which is more like a pea coat. Looks nice, but it was a bit too tight. Like if I've got a chunky jacket underneath there, I wouldn't be able to close it at all. And then there's this Zara woman that looks like a military inspired jacket, but the shoulders were too bulgy. I don't know if the shoulder pads were displaced or whatever, but yeah, it just wasn't me. And there was also a pair of white Geox, am I saying that right? I don't know, loafers. I also looked at that. It was my size, but even though it was a size 37, it was, I guess because it was already used, it was a little bit too loose for me. Like the front part where my foot is covered was perfect, but the back part kept slipping off. So I was like, this is going to annoy me, especially if I'm wearing those invisible socks, that it's going to keep pulling off the invisible sock and then it's going to keep slipping off of my foot. So I'm like, no way, never mind. So I left. after that, I went to another U-turn vintage, and there was this really cute sort of, I think it was by Zara. It was an Oxford pair of shoes, and it had sort of like a leather and fabric, almost like canvas, untreated canvas combination. But I was like the heel was olive green, and then the sides were burgundy, and then the tip of the toe was brown. And I was like, this looks cute. I didn't buy it. Right. So that's what the fourth place. Was it just the fourth? One, two. Oh, I also went to Cardigan Corner after I went to Knopf's Op Shop just after there. And I was just looking through. I was trying to find the perfect pair of high-rise jeans that would be suitable for me. Yeah, so I went there, but I didn't buy anything from there either. I didn't even try on anything. So yeah, I went Cardigan Corner, then the Red Cross, then that U-turn vintage. There was one other place. There was another vintage place, but they were more like young designs that like with really loud colors that wasn't really my style. So I just didn't even go there. So that's sixth. Then the seventh place that I went to was Vinny's on, still on King Street in Newtown. And I was like, oh, maybe I'll find something in here. And I tried on three pairs of jeans. I still didn't find the perfect high-rise jeans for me. I went to the coat section. I don't know. I swear, I don't know what's with me in coats because like it's summer in Sydney. Yeah, so I went to the coat sections. There were a few nice ones, a few designer ones. And I tried one on. I may have put a clip of it. Let me go ahead and put that in. Okay, black Levi's jeans, right length. But what the hell is this? Diesel. But I already have two diesels that are this fit. It's actually quite loose, this one, so that's a no. Nice fit, nice fabric, but I can't close it. And as you can probably tell, it was way too big on me. I mean, the length of the arms were fine, but the shoulders and just the general size of it was not nice. I didn't enjoy it. Okay. So after that, I took the bus and I went to Crown Street in Surrey Hills, and I went to the Knopf's Op Shop there, but by the time I got there, they had already closed. I thought they closed at 5, but apparently they just closed at 4. So I missed it by like half an hour because I arrived there around 4:30. So I walked over to Salvo's on Crown Street, looked around, didn't really find anything that I was interested in, so I left that place again. And then I went to the U-turn vintage on Crown Street, where I had found that Burberry coat that I almost bought instead of the wool coat, or I sort of like had buyer's remorse for this wool coat that I bought because I should have bought that Burberry coat. Anyway, I went back and I was really thinking that, look, $99 for a Burberry coat is not bad. So maybe I should just buy it. That was my whole intention, right? I was gonna buy it. So I took it off the rail. I tried it on. and I could tell the shoulders were too boxy. It didn't have a belt, so it just sort of like made me look like a hanger. I almost looked like a Christmas tree because it was like really shaped like that, and then my legs, you know. So, and but I was still thinking it's Burberry. It's $99 for a Burberry. And then as I was thinking, I put my hands in the pocket, and there it was. There was my solid reason for not buying. The pocket had a huge hole that my entire fist could go through. And I was like, well, I guess it's not for me. And I left. Right? Finally, so 7 in Newtown. Almost 11 if I had been able to go into the Knopf's op shop in Surrey Hills. I would have gone into 11 op shops. The final place that I went to was the Vinnie's on Oxford Street in Surrey Hills. And that's where I bought this wool coat a couple of days back. And I don't know why, but I still went back to the wool coat section. And then I looked at the shoe section, and there was this brown platform loafers from Zara, my size. It didn't even look like it's been used. And I was like, should I? And I was actually holding on to it when I was browsing through the jeans. I tried 6 different pairs of jeans at that Vinnie's, and I almost ended up getting one. It was by Everlane. It was probably a size too tight around the waist area, but that's because I gained quite a bit of weight, which I'm trying to lose, and I'm very confident that I would fit pretty well into those jeans had I bought it. It was only $14, and I was like, Everlane, their like jeans are like $65 US. It's $14 Australian, so, and it was like the right length, the right fabric, the right everything almost. And I'll show you the clip in the the try on room. What is it called? Fitting room. Duh. So yeah, I had 6 pairs of jeans, 5 were like no, 1 was like yes, and I was almost gonna buy it. I returned the Zara shoes, and then I was looking at the pair of jeans and asking myself the question, do I need this? I have 7 pairs of jeans and another denim wide leg trousers. Why would I need the perfect high-rise jeans, right? Where am I gonna use it? And add to this the fact that I have just been told that I would be getting the job that I was applying for, so I would actually be going into a more office environment, like back to the corporate environment. So when would I be wearing all of these pairs of jeans? Just on the weekends. So I thought, $14 on a pair of jeans that would probably have to wait for a couple of months to be worn because I still have jeans that I am not wearing. So, I didn't buy that. There is one thing that I did buy, and this was at the first Vinnie's on King Street in Newtown. And I will show you what it is. It cost me $20. And it's this pair of black boots. I know, I have the Clark boots. And my justification for that was that it had square toes. And I have the Clark boots. I have the Miu Miu knee-high boots. And I still have my Public Desire patent mock croc boots. with this pair of Bali boots, $20. It's size too big for me, to be honest. It's a size 38. I'm usually a 37, and I'm sorry if you are offended by me showing you the bottom of a shoe, but this was like perfect. I tried it on, it fit me like a glove, and it's Bali, and it's $20, and it is pure leather, beautiful leather, made in Italy. There you go. So I am going to be redonating my Clarks square toe boots. I was thinking of a reason why, but to be honest, I always have to do a one-to-one when I buy something. So that's one reason why. But also the second reason is, if you remember when I bought that and I showed you it, it was peeling already. The inside of it was peeling already. So I'm like, yeah, I don't think I'm going to buy that. But I still bought it because it was $5, I think. So anyway, I'm going to redonate that. It's still got really good potential. And then I am actually thinking that now that I have this, I would donate my Public Desire mock croc as well, because one of my problems with that is that the heel is too high. It's very difficult for me to walk in it. So yeah, I'll be donating two pairs of boots so that I can keep this one here. I think there was another pair of shoes that I was wanting at the U-turn vintage, the second U-turn vintage that I went to. And I think I took a clip of that because I just now remembered that the reason why I didn't want to buy that. And I think it was an Enzo Anglioni pair of shoes. Was one, the color is very similar to a pair that I already have. And two, because the insides were peeling. And I only realized it when I took it off from my foot and flakes of the light lining material, like, it was the same color as the inside of this pair of boots. Like, it was already flaking and I could see it falling off of my foot after I had taken it out. Now this pair, you can see, has sort of like the gray lining on there. It isn't meant to be gray. I think it's been stretched too much and some of it is also peeling. So I am just gonna go ahead and paint that with my black leather paint so that it doesn't show, and then I'm going to condition it with my shoe conditioner. Yep. Okay, I think we're good. I should have actually checked if the zipper for both was working. Yeah, see, this is, I am not a very good thrifter. Yeah, they're both working. Perfect. Okay. Yep. So yeah. And what I really also liked about this pair is that it makes my feet look big, because for my height and my size, my feet look like baby feet. Like, they're so small. I wear a size UK 4, a US 6, or a European 37. I think it's all the American and the Australian sizes are the same. So it's also Australian 6. And they look very, very small against my frame. I'm not very tall, but for my height of 5 feet 4, and because I have a short torso and long legs, having small feet looks really weird. Okay. All right. Yeah, and that's my vlog for today. I don't know what to say. Yeah. So I technically still have $20 left on my $100 budget for the month. Okay. Yeah. I'll see you all again in the next video. What? I'll see you all again in the next video. Thanks. Bye.